So with this, I would like to introduce a wonderful speaker we have with us, Richa Das, today. Richa Das is a licensed clinical hypnotherapist, a Reiki grandmaster, and a Akashic Records healer. She is also an ex-banker with 15 years of investment and transaction banking experience with topmost banks. Midst of the hustle, bustle of climbing the corporate ladder, she felt a strong need to fulfill her life's purpose in the area of healing. This arena has helped a strong fascination for her since youth. She became a Reiki healer when she was 18 years old. She is now a Reiki grandmaster. She had questions about life and its purpose, which led her to continue her to study Reiki, neuro-linguistic programming, hypnotherapy, and Akashic Records healing. She has acquired specialization in clinical hypnotherapy, life between life, spiritual regression, past life regression, and inner child work, Akashic Records healing and teaching, Reiki healing and teaching. Her ethos in life comes from this paradigm from Pierre D. Cardin. We are not human beings having a spiritual experience. We are spiritual beings having a human experience. She is passionate about handcrafting jewelry with Reiki-infused semi-precious crystals and making soaps, perfumes, lipstick, and serums, which she retails through her Facebook page, Samairaya Blessings. She is an avid painter and dancing uses her feet wings. Yes, with this, I personally welcome Richa Das. I have been trained in Akashic by Richa. It's a phenomenal experience. Although we got connected in the last 1 month, it's very deep, the connection I could feel. The mutual feeling we had is very, very wonderful. Thank you, Richa, for being here with us.
Thank you, Veena. You're very, very kind in the way you welcomed me and your entire team. You've all been wonderful, absolutely. So as I was also praising Veena, she's a wonderful soul herself. So when she asked me that, do you want to do this and do this for us? I welcomed it as an opportunity because this is something that I was doing pre-pandemic days, though I was doing it very much in an offline mode. I had a weekly meditation class running and there were several students who were feeling a need for this kind of therapy or this kind of a meditation format. And of course, Veena has given me that platform. So, you know, thank you so much, Veena. So, you know, it is, it's also something that I felt as a need. So we are both, you know, meeting each other's requirements or needs. So it's a collaboration of effort, of course. So thank you so much for joining in today. So let's talk a little bit about Ho'oponopono. The word Ho'oponopono comes from a Hawaiian form and it's actually in Hawaiian language. And it means I correct as I speak, I create as I speak. So the word Ho'oponopono is repeated twice to indicate that we correct and we create as we speak. Now there's a little bit of a story about it. The origins of Ho'oponopono are ancient. It's a shamanic form of healing. When we say shamanic form, these are forms of healing wherein the healing occurs with the elements. The healing occurs with Mother Earth. And Hawaii and all that Hawaii has done, you know, it has a very deeply rich culture, almost as rich as Indian culture when it comes to healing. And this is where we are borrowing these concepts from and are using this today in a healing format. And that's what we are going to do today. So what I'm going to talk about comes from Morna Simona. Morna Simona was a kahuna. A kahuna is someone who talks about healing or talks about knowledge through a format of storytelling. So she was a kahuna and she passed on her knowledge to a Hawaiian psychiatrist. His name was Dr. Hewlin. Now the modern form of Ho'oponopono or self-identity through Ho'oponopono, as it is popularly known as SEETH, this is the format that we are looking at today. However, the original form has a 12-line prayer and it's deeper in nature. Okay, so that is what we are going to look at when, you know, if you want to study Ho'oponopono in its entirety, you need to go back to the 12-line prayer. But for my everyday practice, the 4 lines that I'm going to teach you all today is sufficient actually to lead a wonderfully balanced, empowered life. Of course, like anything else, it requires practice and a consistent one at that. I have been with Ho'oponopono close to 8 years now. I learned it 8 years ago and my hypnotherapy mentor taught me. So I'm just carrying forward the tradition of teaching others as I came to know. Okay, So let me tell you a little bit story about Ho'oponopono here. And this is Dr. Hewlett's story. So he had learned Ho'oponopono in the original form by Mona Simona, and he knew how the practice progressed. It is a practice of oneness, it's a practice of forgiveness, and it's a practice of gratitude and love. So it has in its entirety, in its element, actually everything that we do aspire for, or what actually life means. So Dr. Hewlett was actually made in charge of a ward of criminally insane patients, and he was supposed to look after them. Now, this hospital had a very high degree of personnel turnover. You know, people would join, they would leave. They were unable to manage the people who are there, the inmates, because the inmates were all criminally insane. They were chained and all of that. So Dr. Hewlett was at its wit's end, because he had tried everything and nothing was working. Then he remembered Ho'oponopono. And he said, okay, I don't know this format. So let me practice this with each of these 22 inmates that he was responsible for. What he basically did was, he owned the responsibility of their madness in himself. And he calls that madness darkness. What he used to do was, he would take the file of every inmate and say these lines to the files, by owning the responsibility to say that the madness that's there in the inmates, a degree of that, or a very small percentage of that darkness, is there in me as well. And to that darkness, I say these four lines: please forgive me, I am sorry, I love you, I thank you. And he started practicing this. He did this practice for close to 2 years. In the 2 years' time, what was noticed, that the entire ward had to be shut down, because 20 out of those 22 actually healed. They became all right. And there were two who needed to be transferred out of that ward. So this was a medical miracle, and it came to the attention of newspapers and other media links. And through these media links, another gentleman, his name is Dr. Joey Vitale, you may know of him from the book The Secret, he came to know of him, of Dr. Hewlett. So he reached out to him, asked him about this method, asked him how it works, what does it exactly do, and he adopted this format in its modern form, which is the four lines that I talked about in his book Zero Limits. So what I am also talking about is based on these four lines itself. However, the origins are from the 12 line oneness prayer, which Mona Simona has put forward. All of these prayers and their original formats are available on YouTube. If you just type these names, you can get them. The meditation that I am going to do today with all of you is based on these prayers, though I have channeled the complete meditation for your benefit. Yes, the whole concept of Ho'oponopono comes from that fact that we are a part of oneness, of one energy field. If there is a darkness somewhere, if there is something that is out of balance, that out of balance is in some way, in some percentage, in our souls as well, in our own energetic systems as well. As we continue to say to ourselves, please forgive me, I am sorry, I love you, I thank you, any incompatible energy then gets transmuted into forgiveness, love, and gratitude. And that's the essence of Ho'oponopono. And that's what we are going to do today. Yeah, I am doing this meditation without any music. You are encouraged to put on a piece of music in case you like on your side, but the music needs to be an instrumental one. As long as you can clearly hear my instructions and you can clearly hear what I am speaking. I am also going to play a very gentle music on my side so that there is no disturbance from the overall meditation format. So please be with me as I start the music going. So let's begin by closing your eyes. Begin by taking 3 deep breaths. Breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth. As you prepare for the Ho'oponopono experience, I encourage all of you to be seated in a very comfortable space with your back fully supported and your feet flat on the ground. If you're seated on your beds or you are seated in a Sukhasana position, that's also perfectly all right. Just make sure your ankles are not fully crossed. If they are crossed, they create a energy circuit breakdown. So just take care of this bit. Yes. Continue to breathe deeply and completely. Focus on your breathing. As you do that, your stomach fully expands. And as you breathe out, it fully contracts, almost like a balloon. Stay with this experience as you continue to breathe fully, totally and completely. Focus on your breath, on your stomach contracting and expanding with every in-breath and out-breath. As you continue to breathe deeply and completely, you realize that you are in the here and now. In this moment, completely in your mind, body, and spirit. And you realize that at this point in time, all is well. All that you need to know is with you. At this point, you realize that your thoughts are slowing down. With every breath you take, you're coming into a place of oneness. You're realizing that you're perfectly aligned to your highest good and to the highest good of everyone connected to us. You know and realize that you're connecting to your authentic whole, to your higher self now. Your breath is the vehicle that is taking you there as you continue to breathe deeply and completely, and you continue to focus on your breath. Now we begin to tune in to the Ho'oponopono prayer. The first line, I am sorry. Please hold your hands on your heart. Place them physically on your heart like this. And as you continue to place your hands on your heart, feel the warmth of your hands on your heart now. You feel compassion for yourself deep within you, warming you inside out. Stay with your experience as you experience true compassion for yourself with the words, I am sorry. I am sorry. I am sorry. Stay with your experience. Take another deep breath in and let go. As you exhale, completely let go of that breath. And take another deep breath in. And as you do that, you move into the second line of the prayer. Please forgive me. You continue to hold your hands over your heart as you say, please forgive me. And as you do this, notice the responses in your body, in your physical body, as you allow this energy of forgiveness to move through you into every cell, muscle, tissue, fiber and bone in your being, the energy of forgiveness. It is continuing to circulate inside you fully, like a warm energy, like a warm breeze. And you can feel its warmth. It's very comfortable, loving, light, without judgment, this energy. It's saying, please forgive me. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Take another deep breath in and let go. And we move into the third line of the prayer. I love you. I love you. I love you. As you say this to yourself, to your body, you ask your body now to open up. Imagine the energy of unconditional love, almost like a pink colored cloud, or maybe a green one. You can choose the color that you like. This energy of unconditional love moves into your surrounding energy field, or your aura, your own electromagnetic field, and this energy starts to surround you. It allows you to gently open up from inside in your physical body as you continue to say these words to yourself. I love you. I love you. I love you. Stay with this experience. Take another deep breath in and let go. Move to the fourth line of the prayer now. We are moving into the closing line of the prayer, which says, I thank you. As you say these words to yourself, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. You realize waves of gratitude filling you up, wafting, flowing through you, around you. This is a cleansing energy, a clearing energy, an illuminating energy. This energy of gratitude is clearing away past choices, deeds, actions, patterns that no longer serve you in the here and now. This is an energy of the light, gratitude. And it is filling you up now, almost like a warmth which is spilling from inside. And you realize as you continue to say, I thank you, this light from inside is building up. And this light is charging you up all the way inside. Every cell, tissue, muscle, fiber and bone in your being is now recognizing and knowing the energy of love, gratitude, and forgiveness. As you continue to repeat in your minds, please forgive me. I am sorry. I love you. I thank you. Please forgive me. I am sorry. I love you. I thank you. Please forgive me. I am sorry. I love you. I thank you. You allow this energy to fill you up fully, moving inside you fully. This is the time to let go. If there are emotions building up, just release them. Do not resist anything. Do not judge anything. Do not fear anything. And from this place of gratitude, love, and forgiveness, you're allowing this energy now to expand, filling up the space where you're sitting now, and allowing it to fill up the room. This is an infinite energy, and you have an infinite resource of this energy. And you're allowing it to fill up this room where you are sitting. And then possibly the space where you are, your apartment, your house, your building. And moving beyond that to the region where you stay, your colony, your city, the state, and then the country where you are. And you're allowing the energy of Ho'oponopono. Please forgive me. I am sorry. I love you. I thank you to fill up the world. It's a glowing, beautiful, loving, unconditional energy of love, gratitude, and forgiveness. And you can see that the whole world now is bathed in the light of oneness, in the light of unconditional love. Stay with this feeling of expansion and oneness in the here and now. Stay with your experience. Stay with your experience. Stay with your experience. So whenever you're ready, come back to the place where you are, come back to your physical body, to your breath, to this moment in the here and now. Come back very gently, lovingly. Come back and open your eyes. Take your time and open your eyes. I hope everybody's back and feeling good about themselves. Yeah. So it has a very wide application. However, as I'm again repeating, without consistency, this won't work. It's a very simple practice. It's as simple as breathing. So people come back and say, do you think it works? My answer to them is, do you think breathing works? So if breathing works, Ho'oponopono works. Try stopping breathing, then you will know whether Ho'oponopono works. So yes, it works. Of course, you need to practice it consistently. The minimum practice that you need to do is at least 5 minutes a day. And the minimum period is 21 days minimum. So 21 into 5. Because for you to see any lasting change, for you to work on a particular, say, block in your life, or for you to even begin to completely accept and love yourself. It's a kind request to all of you. Please visit my YouTube link as well. There are several meditations there, including this one that I just did. So it's in its entirety, or, spoken in the 22 minutes that I talked about. Yes, and it's fully there for you to enjoy as many times as you want. Yeah, it's available. Please remember to subscribe to Pyramid Times and to my channel. And thank you so much.